Are you a noob but want to be a professional web developer? Welcome to Creative JEE. In this video, I will be showing you best free resources for web design and development. Shivam is here, so you don't need to go anywhere. Let's get started. Starting with the number one free resource, which is free CodeCamp. It provides everything with hundreds of hours of courses, articles, and problems and solutions. Learn from basic to advanced. They also have a YouTube channel. There is a lot, so it's on you how much you want to learn. But I won't say their way of teaching and the instructors are best. So now we have Demi Udemy $10 courses, but you will also find many free courses there. I really learned a lot from the Udemy courses, and you will find many instructors with different teaching styles, and you will also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you didn't like the course, just return it and buy another. I have made a list on Medium for the best courses which are on Udemy, so go and check it out. It's really awesome, and Medium also has really great tutorials for web development. And on the next we have is W3 Schools. This website has all the things which you will need to make simple and good looking website. All the tutorials are well arranged so that you can follow it easily. But it doesn't cover all the technologies which are present on the web. So we have MDN, the Mozilla Developer Network. It has all the documentations which you will need. They are well explained in depth. Or if you want all the documentation in just one place, just visit devdocs.io. It's a progressive web app, so you can save it for offline in your local storage to read them without internet. It's made by FreeCodeCamp, so please consider supporting them. You can also enable dark mode by going in preference and few other settings. And on the next, we have interactive video courses on Scrimba. You will be able to modify codes and see them in real time, which the instructor is writing, which seems really amazing to me. And you can interact with everything which is present here. Like, you can download all the codes in zip, make folders, clone workspace, resize browser, play pause anytime. So you should definitely check this out. How amazing it feels, and the instructors are really good. I think I am forgetting the biggest resource. Yeah, you are right. Stack Overflow. You will get the 90% of your problems solved here. And it's the biggest community on the internet. And also, you should know about CSS tricks. They really have great articles on CSS. If you want some challenges, you can check out Code Wars. But FreeCodeCamp also has many great challenges. And now we will look for colors and gradients. The number one, Flat UI Colors, which has best handpicked colors. But do you know there are meaning of colors? And it's psychology, so you should definitely read about them before designing your app. You can read it in this article. And I will be linking all the links in the description of this video, so please don't forget to check it out. And on the number two, we have UI Gradients, which has amazing gradients for your beautiful design. But what if you need to make a color palette? We need it for any design, whether it is an app or web. You can find some great color palettes on color.adobe.com and also on colors.co. Now take a look on material design. Just visit material.io. The material design is developed by Google, and it is the best design ever made. You can learn about all of the concepts here and use it everywhere. You can look into their design, develop, and tool section to provide a great user interface to your user. and they have a great collection of icons. You can use it anywhere, web, Android, iOS, or whatever you want, or wherever you want. You can just use them as SVG or import the material icon from Google Fonts. And they also have a library so that you can manipulate their styles easily, known as Materialize CSS. So just go and check it out. If you want some free and awesome looking icons and images, check out flaticon.com. They are having the best icons. You just need to create them somewhere in your page. And talking about vector images, FreePic has the best vectors. And another one is Undraw, which has quite good looking vectors for your apps. But we also use captured image, so why not to check out pixabay.com. It has a massive collection of images, and after that, pixels, and Unsplash is also there. Every app needs a logo, but what if you want to design it yourself? Just check out this video, it's a great tutorial on logo design. If you want to polish your HTML and CSS skills, check out Dribbble and Behance. They are having really great designs, so you can convert them in real websites and code for it. Now let's talk about online code editors, or IDE, which stands for Integrated Development Environment. CodePen is the choice of front-end developers. You can do almost 90% of your front-end tasks on CodePen. You can create new projects or pens, and after writing your code, just save it and you will be able to share your code and project with anyone through your project link. And it is much easier to set up and use third-party libraries, but when you will start using images in your project, then the problem starts happening, because you will have to upload your images somewhere and then link the URL of the image in your code. But you don't need to worry, because Shivam is in hurry. Just go to codesandbox.io and create a sandbox. You will get many options here, so you can choose accordingly. I will simply choose static, and as here you can see, we have the index.html file. You can create files and folders from here, or you can drag and drop any of the file, but as a free member, it is limited to 20 MB. And as usual, just save the file and share the link of your project or preview the URL. If you haven't watched my video on using code editors like a pro, then please go and watch it. It will really help you writing code better and faster. Wait, are you wondering how to use Node.js, Python, Java, Ruby, Golang, and many more for free in online IDE? So just visit coda.com and create a free account, and after that you can create your new project and just open it with VS Code. Are you shocked? Yeah, this is online Visual Studio Code editor, almost same as your local editor. You can do all sorts of things which you can do in your local machine. Change themes, install extensions, icons, and you are getting a root access of this computer. So open terminal and install whatever you want. Just make sure that you are running your server on port 80. And you will get a preview URL. And for more details, don't forget to read the docs. And it is always going to be free what you are getting for free, so no need to worry. You can always upgrade for more space and speed. Now what if you wanna host or deploy your website for free? If you have a static website made just with HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, you can use GitHub Pages or Netlify. Just make a GitHub account and install Git on your computer and follow the instruction, which is on pages.github.com. And you should be knowing how to use GitHub, because this is the place where you share your projects so that everyone can see and learn something from your codes. And if you don't want others to see your projects, make the repository private. But for that, you will need a subscription or a free GitHub Students Pack. If you don't want the users to see your files for free, then use Netlify. Just drag and drop your static site folder and you are done. You can also add your custom domains for free. Now what if you have a Node app and you want to deploy it? You can use glitch.com. Other people are also having great projects here, so you can remix it for uploading. You can just do that by creating a new project and after that just replace the codes or upload your files by dragging and dropping them. But wait, not everyone uses Node.js. So we have Heroku. You can deploy Node.js, Ruby, Python, Java, PHP, Go, Scala, Clojo, and Kotlin. And keep in mind, your app on free dyno will go to sleep after 30 minutes of inactivity. If you are having problems with hosting on any of the site I mentioned above, just do a little bit of research, you will find your solution. There are hundreds of videos and articles on them. The most important thing to learn in life is not to hook up, it is to look up. There are so many resources, but you will only find it when you will start looking for it. And by just looking, you are not going to be Mark Zuckerberg or Elon Musk. You will have to utilize them efficiently. And at last, we have online communities. You can find those in Gitter Chat. If you have specific doubts and you want me to make a video on that topic or cover some tutorials which you are not able to find, please let me know in the comments. If you want me to keep making these great videos to help you to grow and learn, consider me supporting on Patreon. Hit the dislike button if you hated this video and hit like if you liked it. Share it and don't go without subscribing and hitting
the bell icon.
Thanks for watching and be creative.
Bye bye.